Well over 70,000 people become infected with hepatitis B annually. People are dying by more than 5,000 a year just from hepatitis B virus and from its complications. Some of the symptoms related to hepatitis B are as follows. Yellow skin, or otherwise known as jaundice. Yellowing of the eyes, the whites of the eyes. Tiredness, fatigue, general malaise, the loss of appetite, the dark-colored urine, clay-colored stools, joint pain, night sweats, and this general feeling that I'm getting sick. Not to mention in late stage, you have the jaundice accompanied with sometimes a distended abdomen and a painful abdomen while the inflammation of that and the swelling of that liver is really becoming severe. It's important to realize that a lot of people have this disease in their body in an incubating format for up to 6 months before they really start to show these signs and symptoms. Sometimes it can happen in a couple weeks, but 6 months is a long time to potentially spread this infection to other people through your own body fluids before your signs and symptoms even begin. Another differentiation between hepatitis B and the HIV virus is that hepatitis B is about 100 times more concentrated in the same amount of blood as HIV, thereby giving us a greater chance of actually getting sick from this virus than in the same amount of blood or body fluid exposure which contains HIV. Now, hepatitis B, about 90% of the people that contract that virus, their body actually fights it before and puts it into a submissive role and sometimes even clears the virus completely from the body, thereby giving them a lifelong immunity to hepatitis B infection. And they never ever die from that or become more ill. They have a strong enough immune system, they can fight it, clear it, and go on their merry way. But in the area of the other 10%, they're the ones who are going to actually contract, they're going to have the infection go to their liver, cause the indications that we just talked about, and they're going to become chronic or they're going to die from a some type of problem associated with that hepatitis B infection. Now, the pie chart again shows that the large percentage of people that are getting hepatitis B and having problems from it are not getting them from such things as doorknobs, casual contact, handshakes, kissing, using the same toilet, things like that. We do encourage you not to use the same toothbrush. We don't want people to use different things that like razors where they might have blood on the actual item and then share that and then cut skin and transfer it that way. But as long as it's casual, non-body fluid contact, the people are not getting sick from that. They're getting sick from other things like sexual contact or multiple sexual partners with infected people and IV drug abuse.